Welcome to Cisco Switchboard Security Configuration Lesson, guys. In this lesson, we will configure Cisco Switch with Switchboard Security feature. If you are ready, let's start. In this topology, we have a switch and there are three hubs connected to this switch, and there is also one directly connected PC. There are also other PCs, and here I'll show you four different scenarios with different switchboard security violation modes. If you are ready, let's start with fast Ethernet 0/1 and configure this port for switchboard security. Here, first I'll configure this port with switchboard. Firstly, I will go to interface fast Ethernet 0/1, then I will configure it with switchboard mode access. And then I will configure switchboard security feature, and for this, I'll write switchboard port security command, and after that, I will enter a MAC address. So I will write a static MAC address and I will define the MAC address of this PC. So after this PC can access to this switch. So let's see the MAC address of this switch, this PC. Here you are. This is the MAC address of this PC, and I will define it with switch port, port security, MAC address, and PC's address. Yes. And after that, I will also configure switchboard port security maximum 1. This means that only one MAC address can be defined, can be accessed to this port. So after that, let's write also the violation mode. Here I will use shutdown as violation. This is the default mode of violation modes. So if you don't write, it is also shut down, but I'll write to show you. And yes, this is our configuration on fast Ethernet 0/1. So let's save our configuration. And then let's see, show port security. Fast Ethernet 0/1 is configured with shutdown violation mode, but there is no security violation for now. So we will do a trick here and then we will see this violation. So what will we do? We will delete this link and then I will connect this interface to this PC. So we have configured PC 0's MAC address on this port. So when this port sees the MAC address of PC1, it will go to shutdown mode. All the IP configurations of these PCs are done before this configuration. So the IP address of this PC is 10.0.0.1. And this IP address is also 10.0.0.2, and etc. Let's see again. Show switch port, show port security, sorry. Yes, this is shutdown. And let's go to here. And in this place, in this PC, I'll say ipconfig, then I'll ping 10.10.0.0.2. So after this ping, as you can see, it goes to down because this PC has learned this MAC address, this PC's MAC address, and it knows that it can only access one MAC address on this fast Ethernet 0/1. So let's check this again. And as you can see, here is a security violation. Let's remember, show port security address. And as you can see, we have defined this address for fast Ethernet 0/1. This is secured configured type, and the MAC address of this PC is different than that address. So security violation has occurred. This is the first scenario that I will show you. Let's go to learn the second scenario. In the first example, we have used shutdown as violation mode. So this was the default mode, and it puts the interface, the ports, in error disabled mode. So it also sends an SNMP trap notification to you. It also increased violation counter. So in the next example, we will configure protect mode, and then we will configure restrict mode. What are these protect and restrict modes? So the violation mode protect drops the packets with unknown source addresses until you remove a sufficient number of secure MAC addresses to drop to below the minimum value. It never sends you any notification, and it never increases the violation counter. But restrict mode also drops the packets with unknown source address, but it increased the violation counter, and it also sent you a notification. In the second example here, we will start with the protect example. We will configure fast Ethernet 0/2 with violation mode protect. So let's start to configure it. I'll go to fast Ethernet 0/2 and then switchport mode access, switchport port security, switchport port security maximum 1 again. So under this port we also allow only 1 MAC address. Switchport port security violation protect, switchport port security MAC address sticky. Here we use sticky MAC addresses, and this means that learn the connected MAC addresses and write it to the configuration. Then we will save our configuration. Let's check show port security, and here we have configured it. There are two PCs are connected here, but only one is allowed. I think the first one. Let's check who win this race. Show running config. Oh, sorry. Yes, I forgot something. We should ping from this PC to the other PCs because this switch needs to learn these MAC addresses. So let's go to here. Yes, ping 10. I will ping PC3. Yes, here when we use show running config command, we can see the MAC address of this PC. Let's check. Yes, this is this PC, and this PC is not here. This switch will not write the MAC address of this PC because it only allows one sticky MAC address. So let's also use this command. Here, this is the sticky MAC address learned and allowed on fast Ethernet 0/2. This is the second example. In the third example, we will configure fast Ethernet 0/3. This time, we will configure our violation mode as restrict. So we will also allow only one MAC address here, and we will use it as sticky. And here we have also two connected PCs. So there will be a violation again. But this time you will see the violation counter increase, and we will also see the notifications. Here let's go to interface fast Ethernet 0/3. And then let's configure switch port mode access, switch port, port security, switch port, port security maximum 1, switch port, port security, violation, restrict, and switch port, port security, MAC address, CK. And let's save our configuration. Let's check show port security. Here is fast Ethernet 0/3 and it is in restrict mode. It is configured with restrict mode, but there is no security violation for now. So here we will use ping again. Let's ping 10.10.5, then 6, 7, yes. Let's check the port security table again. And here, as you can see, the violation counter is increased and it's again restrict mode. And let's check show port security address. And here you are. This is the sticky MAC address and it allowed only one MAC address here. So this is the allowed MAC address. So the other MAC address, let's check this one. Yes, this is allowed MAC address. And this is not allowed on this interface. Let's go to our last example, and in this last example, we'll also configure the violation mode as shutdown. So here, there are two PCs, as you can see at the right hand, and there is also another PC that is not connected. So that PC that is not connected will be our violation reason. Let's firstly configure fast Ethernet 0/4. By default, the violation mode is also as shutdown on the ports, but here I am writing this full command to show you. And I will also configure switch port, port security maximum. So here, this port allows only two MAC addresses, two sticky MAC addresses on this port. When we connect the third one, it will go to error disabled mode. Let's check. Yes, it is configured with shutdown. For now, there is no security violation. And here also, let's check the addresses. It is not here. Firstly, we should ping. As you can see, here are the secure sticky MAC addresses. These MAC addresses are the MAC addresses of PC 6 and PC 7. For now, there is no PC 8. Let's connect PC 8 and see this violation. As you can see, when I connect it, it goes to down state. Let's here are the notification, show port security, and yes, this is the violation counter. And also let's see the other options. As you can see, the security violation counter, port status, secure shutdown, port security is enabled, and yes. These addresses are also here again. Yes, because of PC8, this violation occurs. We have finished our port security configuration with 4 different scenarios. If you like this video, please do not forget to like it and sharing with your friends. And if you haven't subscribed to our channel yet, we are waiting for you. Subscribe to our channel, and till next video, good luck.